verse for me both times. In Bot Town, that's automatic, hold down.
What's that?
Ask no questions, just hold it down. Why you hating on the progress? I'm a humble, I don't even project.
What I do?
I just drive the Maybach through the projects. And still brazy, I ain't even drive shit.
Hate from a distance, please don't try me. Cause we'll turn it up on anybody. I see why they don't like me. Yelling out 400, they go too heavy. I'm with the posse back at it.
Whoa.
That mean come on, go on platinum.
Whoa.
That mean I got a kingdom with my mattress. Oh, I got the beady back breaking.
Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. When a team already has a playoff spot in their back pocket, it can be easy to lose focus and ease up late in the regular season. But not losing momentum going into the playoffs is also important, so they just can't mail it in here. It's the Bengals going up against the Texans. So, with the call of this Week 16 matchup, let's hand it over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, it is set to host Super Bowl 51 on February 5th of next year as you take a look inside NRG Stadium here in Houston. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Houston Texans. Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Texan ball club entering play here. They come in riding. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. This is Lamar Miller. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well.
And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Ray Malaluga in there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, 3rd and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
And oh, look at that, a diving catch. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a 4th down.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. And it's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on 4th down conversions. This is a bit tougher. 4th and 4. Now it's Osweiler. And this is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. So shall we say a... This off defense ready to head back out there as they'll take over with a little over a minute to play in this first quarter. Heading out is the Texans offense as they get set to take over here. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Here's Osweiler. And the hookup here with Jalen Strong complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. So one quarter in the books here on Christmas Eve. 14-0 is our score. We're back to Houston in just a moment.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it's Texans football as we get going in quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. They'll throw on first down with Osweiler. Looking for Strong, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Alabama man, Dre Kirkpatrick. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. The start of this next possession, the score 7-0. And now out comes Houston. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
They're up enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it? And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
On the right side, this is Miller. 15 yards through the air and a first down. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Everything about that play was beautiful. A great corner route where the receiver worked the defensive back inside and then broke back to the outside to the corner. But how about the throw by the quarterback? Anticipation. On the break, from inside to outside, he threw the football. As the receiver turned around, the ball greeted him. We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Dumps it complete to Miller. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Again, it's Miller. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
in the red zone this time. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Houston after this timeout. Back now. As I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well read.
Oh, thank you.
Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
From the shotgun, Osweiler. His pass caught at the 4. No gain there on the completion. It'll be second down. Now, the old pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now, with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take care of the ball in open field.
And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Lamar Miller with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Texans have cut it to within a score. Well, he wasn't the guy they were initially going for, but after going through the progressions, it worked.
When you have plenty of people who can catch the football, you don't always have to go to your primary target. And sometimes.
Offense will head back out there, already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. And now out comes Houston. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drives.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Osweiler. Completion left side to Miller. Touchdown, Houston. Braxton Miller, his second touchdown on the season. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football. The 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
Let's go!
On first down, Osweiler. Gets it to Strong. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line. So we are at halftime here on Christmas Eve. As we send you on over to Orlando, where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Texans have been solid in the secondary to this point. The Bengals have struggled to throw the football two straight weeks, so that's something they'll try to fix in the second half. All right, let's roll those highlights. Texans have it midway through the first. They're going to get to the QB once again. This will go for a loss of 7. Texans lined up at the 20. Here the defense will come up with the pick. Kirkpatrick's the one who makes the pick to give a boost to his defense. Offense out now following the INT. The catch is made in double coverage, and he capped off the long drive with the TD. Now trailing by 7. First and 10, Osweiler is going to complete the pass into coverage, and this two-play drive goes for a touchdown, cutting the deficit to 7. And with that, we'll wrap up our halftime report and head back out now to Texan Stadium for the start of the second half.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Bengals defense gearing up as they take the field. And a big reason they've got the lead here in the second half, they have been swarming to the football and laying some big hits.
Yes, this is not the woodwinds or the string section at all in the band, is it? Straight percussion, and you can feel the thumps all the way up here.
Second down. Wide open receiver complete. Will Fuller, nobody there to stop him. Touchdown, Houston. Will Fuller, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
He's got it, and we're all tied at 21. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And heading back onto the field now, the Texans defense. And they gave up a touchdown last drive. You kind of need to hit the reset button after every touchdown given up, Charles.
I love that. And the way that you phrased it is perfect, because from series
under heavy pressure, and down goes Dalton on the sack. The four-time All-Pro, J.J. Watt, in there to drop him, and his great season continues. 13 sacks for him now on the year. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
The play fake to Hill. Dalton. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Bernardrick McKinney in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. Now fourth down. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Taken from just outside the 30. Wow, evasive.
Make a miss.
Nice job on the return there. 16 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And here comes the Texans now. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way, because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask. 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play, and the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Man, it wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
On second down, here's Miller. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Brandon, there's no doubt the defense has to be excited after stacking up back-to-back running plays. But I still remember my old coaches saying, after you've had some success, you better be careful. They might have an answer for you. So make sure you watch your keys, play your techniques, and don't get overconfident.
Jalen Strong, the intended receiver. And that brings up fourth down. Here's Shane Leckler now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And out now, here come the Bengals. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Now, that result is no surprise. This team is bringing back memories of what? The 85 Bears, the 2000 Ravens. Those teams were so great against the run, they made you abandon any plans of doing that when you played against them. Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on third and 14. Third and long. What will Dalton dial up? Complete to the right side. It's Eifert. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. We're off to the fourth quarter here on Christmas Eve. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. On second down, Hill. And some space here. And he'll cut it out to the sideline. And all the way down to the five. A big play there for Cincinnati. And even 60 yards on the ground. Well, they know they've got a good starter. Now the guy coming in to spell him shows he can run it pretty good as well.
And I think he appreciates the starter, wearing people down, tiring them out a little bit. He took full advantage, didn't he? Came in with fresh legs and carried the ball.
First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Jeremy Hill, his third touchdown of the game, number 16 on the season. And the Bengals have broken our tie as they take the lead. He's got the hat trick now of rushing touchdowns. Also has his team the advantage.
And I'm looking at it two ways here. If I'm on defense, I don't care what they do now. I commit as many people as it takes to slowing him down running the football. Even if they want to hit me over the top on play action, I just don't let him beat me that way anymore. And if I'm him, I'm in the huddle calling the plays myself. I don't care what play call comes in. I tell my quarterback, guess what? You're handing it to me again.
And if I'm the quarterback, I'm saying, okay, that sounds good, right?
Smart quarterback.
This will be taken in at the one. Oh, it shifts past him. Now the Bengals defense readies as they head onto the field. They'll be hoping to come up with that same type of effort they had last time when they forced the punt that led to a touchdown.
And that type of effort just continues to carry over, because once you get it done once, you feel like you can do it again and again. No guarantee, but you got to like the confidence that they take back out into the field.
Now will they keep that confidence? Time to find out. And he takes this down deep into Cincinnati territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 59 yards. Let's discuss now this performance as it relates to the last one. You know, a week ago, and we saw it. Some pinpoint accuracy. He's displaying that again.
That was a fun film session for us, wasn't it? Able to kick back and watch him work. And what we saw was a confident leader, a guy in control, making excellent throws at times. And he's brought that with him in this ball game as well. And starting to think that he's starting to feel like, yeah, I've got this thing down pat. And I think the team will come along with him.
All right, here we go.
They'll run it again with Miller. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards down to the 10.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
I got trips this side, I got trips this side. We got three.
Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
An expecting pass. Osweiler, and this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. So a costly penalty, and now a tougher third down situation. Out of the gun, it's Osweiler. And finding Fedorowicz. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And let's discuss Osweiler a little bit further. Obviously, an interesting journey for him to get here to Houston.
Groomed in Denver and actually got to play some before he ended up making his departure to Houston. But after the Broncos won the Super Bowl, I think he was in search of his own team and his own destiny as maybe a Super Bowl quarterback. They gave him a great opportunity, and he took advantage of it and headed to be a Texan.
And leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense. On second down, here's Osweiler. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Jalen Strong, touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
And the offense can string something together, but they'll need to do it quickly here to try to get points on the board and win this game.
Zebra! Zebra!
And Dalton hands to Hill. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They run it again with Hill, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. He could muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a third and very short. Even score late in the fourth. Let's see if the defense can play within themselves, not give up the big play and contain, and keep this knotted up. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset, and they're facing a big third down now in this tie ball game. And how about the dime look here? Six DBs on third and inches.
Daring them to run the ball.
And Dalton to throw. And And this is going to be incomplete. Brandon LaFell, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up a fourth down.
I have to say, that was a surprise call on third and inches. I thought they'd try and run the football there, but you got to believe they thought they'd surprise the defense and pick up something downfield, but that one goes incomplete.
Taking it about the 16.
Personal foul. Roughing the kicker. Defense.
Oh, and you just can't do that. 15 yards on the roughing the kicker call.
Absolutely inexcusable. The kicker's in a defenseless position, and he just gets taken out.
So now Dalton. Green's got it over the middle, and he's brought down. 20 yards on the pickup there, and that'll be good enough for a Cincinnati first. Now the offense lining up first and 10. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let him know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, when they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Penalty, it's Hill. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Jadeveon Clowney there on the stop. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Carry down for Rex Burkhead. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They come out here in the eye. On third down, here's Hill. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough. And it'll be fourth down. And now the Texans are going to stop it as they signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And Nugent puts it through, and the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. And Charles, he hasn't missed a kick all year. Why would he start now?
Exactly. And this was by far the most nerve-wracking. They just stepped up and calmly banged it through.
This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll bring it a few. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here as we step aside. Fresh set of downs here.
Let's go.
One last shot for Osweiler. Gets it to Strong. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Bengals, they continue to rack up the victories as this one moves them to 13-2 on the year. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for Houston, it's a bad time of year to take a loss like this as they drop to 10-5. And they'll try to rebound next week on the road in Nashville. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.
Internet, no respect, haven't moved out of your parents' basement yet. Big neck, coming with the beat that's gonna break your neck.
Yeah, you can hear me.